right here in front of me.
What's up, fishaholics? I'm down here on the south end of Lake Ida Canal, and I just spotted my first peacock bass, which is what I'm gonna be targeting today. But I wouldn't be complaining if I catch a bunch of nice largemouth bass and whatever else bends the rod. I just spotted this peacock bass right on the other side of this pipe right here, and a drain. And I just spotted a peacock bass who's sitting over here on the left side of this pipe. And I threw a little walk the dog type bait. He didn't really react to it, so I'm gonna throw on something different, like a soft plastic jerk bait or a Lunker City finesse fish, and hopefully connect to the fish. But let's try and catch some peacocks today.
All right, guys, well, after trying to catch that first peacock that I saw, you know, for 20, 30 minutes, I couldn't trigger a reaction, I couldn't get a bite. I fished up and down the canal everywhere, you know, under tall bridges, under short bridges, wherever I could basically move along the shoreline and have easy access, but I didn't have any luck. I eventually returned to the same area where I saw my first peacock, thinking maybe he came back to that same spot to sun himself, but that never was the case. So I continued working my way down the shoreline, and I came to a fish that I thought was a peacock bass, but it ended up being something entirely different.
I got a peacock bass right here in front of me. Not a big one, but a nice one. Got him. Tilapia, rather. Tilapia. Whoa. It's my first tilapia. I believe it's a tilapia. Thought it was a peacock bass for a second. Cool looking fish. Looks like he's blind in one eye. Never caught one before. It's pretty cool. First fish of the day. Trying to catch a peacock still.
All right, guys, well, after catching a tilapia that I thought was a peacock bass, I decided to move north to Lake Ida Park. And by this time, I've already been fishing for, you know, 3.5, almost 4 hours. And I started to get discouraged, and I started to really get focused in on wanting to catch that peacock bass. You know, I went fishing in the sticks. I went fishing everywhere I could have easy shore access and non-easy shore access. I mean, I was, you know, really going into the trees and the bushes to try and find peacock bass. I had to really check for ticks after, you know, make sure I don't get Lyme disease. But anyways, it ended up I didn't find any peacock bass fishing up in Lake Ida. So I decided then eventually to turn around and start fishing south, because I was thinking, well, hey, you know, peacock bass love the warmer water. You know, they're from the Amazon, so they love that warmer water. They're going to be probably a little bit further south. So then, basically, I kept fishing south, and then this happened, where I had suntan lotion on my hands, and I decided to wipe the lens, because I thought I had water on there, with my suntan lotion-covered hand. And therefore, for the rest of the day, I had a lens that was a little blurred because of the suntan lotion. But I was able to get into some nice fish.
Fish on. Fish on. Whoa, nice largemouth. Whoa, this guy's a fighter. He ate that RC stick. It's probably an easy 3.5 pound bass. Not a bad one. Oh. That's a pig right there. Not bad at all. I almost thought it was a peacock bass for a second, the way he jumped out of the water. Nice fish just on that RC stick. Probably around a 17, 18 inch bass. Probably around 3.5 pounds. Maybe 3.75. Nice fish though. Smash that RC stick suspending jerkbait. Fish on. Largemouth, nice chunky largemouth. a nice one. It's not a peacock bass, but you know, a nice 2-pounder. I'm almost done for the day. I've been out here for, I think, 8 hours or so, pretty much fishing. And I've seen 2 peacock bass, but haven't been able to catch one.
All right, guys, so after catching that last bass, I decided to call it a day and start working my way back to my car. I had about a 2-mile walk back along the canal because that's how far I fished and how much canal water I actually fished. I fished about 2 miles of canal south of Lake Ida Park. And I had a long walk back. You know, I was sharing the car that I was using, so I decided to call it a day and we'll be back tomorrow in my hunt for a peacock bass.
I started around 9 a.m. Right now it's 7:30 a.m. and I'm gonna try and give it a shot. I think the conditions are a lot better this morning. It's a lot earlier, and I have another bait that I'm gonna try. I'm gonna try a soft plastic jerk bait, which I think will be a little bit better than a hard bait or a Lunker City finesse fish on a jig head. But let's see what happens. Hopefully I can catch a peacock on day 5 today. I might even head down to Miami today after I fish a few key areas where I actually saw peacock bass yesterday. And if I can't catch any peacock bass where I saw them, I'm gonna head south. I'm gonna give it like an hour or two. Yesterday I pretty much fished all day locally when I probably should have left and went down south to an area where I know there are peacock bass in a small little canal. Fish on. Oh, not a peacock. Nice little bass. This is like what happened yesterday. I saw a peacock, or I was fishing for one, and I caught a little largemouth about the same size on a Lunker City finesse fish. These bass down here in Florida sure do fight hard. They're crazy. All right, I'm gonna get out of here and head south to Miami, fish another area, and hopefully have a better shot at connecting with the peacock bass. About halfway there to Miami. You know, got about 30 minutes left or 20 minutes left to drive. I'm pretty excited. I'm gonna, you know, head down there. I'm gonna have about, you know, 3 solid hours to fish, 3-4 hours, you know, and then I'm gonna have to head back up north so I can, you know, hang out with the boys and, you know, we're gonna go to the beach and, you know, maybe do some saltwater fishing and swim around a little bit, maybe meet some girls. But, you know, I'm really hoping that this little drive here is gonna be worth it. Hopefully I'll get into some peacock bass. All right, guys, down here in Miami. Took me about an hour and 20 to get down here to fish this little canal here. Oh, I got a baby peacock bass. He's following it. Baby peacock bass, I see him down there. Small little guy. So there's peacock bass in here. I'm seeing a lot of smaller size peacocks in the canal here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put on an X-wrap suspending jerkbait, and that'll be a little bit easier than this big soft jerkbait for them to get into their mouth. They're really, you know, aggressive. They're swimming up to this jerkbait like they want it, but they just can't eat it. So even if I catch a 5-inch peacock bass, I'd be happy. Oh my gosh, got a big one right along this concrete thing here. Really big peacock. I don't know, I mean, not really big, but maybe at least 3 pounds. This peacock bass isn't that aggressive. He's not going for it. Fish on. I don't know what this is. I think like a cichlid or a tilapia, I think, but they just came up and smashed this little Rapala X-Wrap. I have no clue what this fish is. Really cool looking. If you guys know what this is, post it in the comment section below. Got some good teeth on them. Wow, got a massive snook in here. Right in front of me. Holy crap, I've never seen a snook that big. There he is, peacock. Yes! Woo! There he is. He came up and... Oh! Woo! First peacock of Florida. There we go. He like didn't even really eat it that well, but thinking I hooked him in the side. It's all right though, I didn't penetrate him too bad. There was three peacocks there fighting for it. I just saw a massive snook, and then I hooked this nice little peacock. Finally! I've been trying to catch a peacock bass for 3 days since I've been down here. What a pretty fish, what a pretty fish.
Just give you another closer look at this beautiful peacock. My first ever peacock bass. I am so stoked. I'm ready to catch some more, let's go. Get a nice release on this beautiful little peacock bass. There he goes.
I just saw a massive tarpon in here. My camera was off, but he came up and flashed at my little X-Wrap. I'm gonna be in trouble if I hook him on this tackle, or at least this 12-pound test line. There he is, peacock. Whoa, he jumped out of the water. Oh my gosh. Crazy peacock, jumped right out of the water. There he is, peacock, on the Rippin wrap. Oh, nice, got him. A little bit smaller than my first one, or about the same size. Woo, nice pretty peacock. I love that tail they have. I just love it. It's a pretty tail. It's a gorgeous fish. See you later, buddy. There he is, another one. Oh, another little peacock. This one's got some cool little spots on them. They're liking this Rapala Rippin wrap. It's a cute little guy. Look at that tail. That tail is beautiful. Nice little peacock. They're not big yet. I'm hoping to at least get one over 10 inches or over 15 inches. So I'm gonna keep fishing. There he goes. There he is. Oh, another peacock. Woo! That's a little bigger. It's probably the biggest one of the day right there. What a pretty fish. I'm gonna get a quick picture of this guy and then get him back in the water. It definitely paid off coming down to Miami to catch some peacock bass. They're not big, but they fight really hard. Crazy fish. There he is. Little baby peacock. There's a lot of little peacock in this canal, but that doesn't bother me. At least I'm catching some. And how I'm fishing this Rapala Rippin wrap is basically just letting it sink down near or on the bottom and ripping it up so I don't get any weeds, and then just basically yo-yoing it back towards myself. There he is. Oh, one of those cichlid things. Look how orange that is. Wow, pretty colors. They're loving the Rippin wrap just as much as the peacocks are. Ow. They got spines like bluegills. There he is. On the fall, Another little peacock. I wish I came here yesterday. I did see peacocks yesterday, but I just couldn't get them to bite. There he is. Oh, it's a largemouth. Nice largemouth on that Rapala Rippin wrap. This guy fights pretty hard. Thought it was gonna be a bigger peacock. Now all I need to do is catch a peacock about this size and I'll be really happy. Nice bass. It's almost time for me to go. I gotta head back up north. And me and the boys are gonna hit the beach, but I think I can fish for about another 20 minutes and then I gotta head out of here. Damn, I just had a big peacock following this. My Rapala X-Wrap got tangled. I just had a massive peacock follow it in though. I mean, not massive, I'm saying massive because the ones that I've caught today have only been 10 inches, but this one here is probably at least a 3-pounder. Darn, that was a nice sized peacock. Right there under that bridge, there's gotta be one under there. Come on, peacock, where are you? There he is, got him. Whoa, they're fast. Fast little guy. Probably the biggest one of the day right there. Oh, and he fell off the hook. Nice peacock. Just so pretty that tail. I love it. Oh, there he is. Oh my gosh, this is so fast. Oh, nice, pretty peacock. This one had the most attitude out of all of them. I think this is a different type of peacock. It's got a different pattern on the side of them. Pretty gorgeous fish. I have got to get a picture of this peacock. Wow, not huge, you know, probably only around 10 inches, but man, they fight ridiculously hard. I can't imagine what it would be like to hook into one that's like 4 or 5 pounds. Wow. There he is. Nice peacock. They're crazy, these guys. All right, guys, I'm gonna call it for the day. I gotta head up north and me and the guys are gonna hit the beach. You know, we're sharing a car, so I can't be fishing all day and have the car. But anyways, today definitely was a great idea coming down south a little bit more to Miami and fishing a key area that I knew had peacock bass in it, and it was a lot smaller area, so I knew my success rate was a lot higher than where I was fishing on day 4 yesterday. And yesterday was a good day. I mean, I did catch a lot of bass. I caught a good amount of largemouth, even though I was targeting peacocks. But, you know, the peacocks that I did see, they were a little bigger, but I couldn't get them to eat anything, you know? And what's the use of fish that don't bite? So, you know, I made that decision to hit that same spot, though, but a little earlier, and, you know, see if those fish were maybe active, but they weren't. So then I was like, all right, you know what? I'm going to come down south, go to a spot I know has fish, and try and catch some peacocks, because that's what I really wanted to catch today. And you know, I caught a bunch of peacocks today, maybe 15 or so. You know, probably had 20 on, lost, you know, a few. But they weren't big, they were all from, you know, 5 inches to about 12 inches. But they fight like a ton of bricks. They hit like a ton of bricks. You know, it was a great experience to catch them. If you haven't caught a peacock bass, you should head down to Florida, maybe start in Miami, and you know, try and catch some peacock bass. And also, today was an interesting day, because you know, I also saw some snook in here, and you know, I actually had a tarpon swipe at my lure, and that's good news to know that there's, you know, a bunch of variety of saltwater and freshwater species in this canal here. So for future
you know, purposes, I can come down here and hopefully target some snook or some tarpon. But anyways, thanks for watching. Please check out my earlier videos of Florida fishing or my earlier videos of just fishing, period. And don't forget to subscribe so you know when I post future videos. And don't forget to look in the description for how I was catching fish today. If you have a question, post it in the comment section below. Thanks again for watching, guys.